So anyhow, like I said, I had a good time.
Yeah.
It was a good life.
Yeah.
But my father always wanted me to go to America, you know.
Why is that?
Because my father had never been, but he shipped cattle to America, and my grandfather shipped 1,000 cattle a year to America years ago, in the 20s. But I remember, you know, when they had the moon landing, Sid Spence wasn't in America at that time. I was at the quarantine.
Right.
And we were invited over to the television. And he told us, have you ever seen anything like this? You haven't got televisions in Europe. I said, for fuck's sake, we've got everything in Europe, as much as you got in America. And he got us annoyed because he thought we were really peasants, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we went in there in his house and we saw the moon landing and all. It was really interesting, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But do you believe the moon landing was fake? Some say it was, you know.
So going to New York City was a really big thing for me. And on top of that, it was quite a surprise and a great honor to be selected to receive this calf, Precious Galinthia, from the Isle of Jersey and representing New Jersey on their 300th birthday. So I made my own dress for the event because I was in 4-H. It was like a pale turquoise. And I remember it had little gathers at the waist with two fancy little bows as decoration. But the most exciting thing was for the actual presentation. After the birthday cake was presented in the shape of the state of New Jersey, and we had that cutting ceremony, then they brought me up on the stage and presented me with the calf, and they gave me the microphone in front of this, what to me was a humongous crowd of people, several thousand people in the pavilion, and asked me to say a few words. So I talked about what an honor it was and how I loved the Jersey cows.
So we were the village of Carteret, which was part of Woodbridge Township. And there's reference to this Carteret section of Woodbridge Township from the late 1700s and early 1800s, historically. Then in 1922, the residents have another question, another public question referendum, and they decide that we're going to go back to the borough of Carteret versus the borough of Roosevelt. Because everything was Carteret. Regardless of that, we were officially the borough of Roosevelt. It was the Carteret Post Office, the Carteret Schools, Historically, you know, it had been Carteret for 150 or 200 years before. So for them to change the name, I think, was short-sighted on their part. First things I did when I was elected mayor 12 years ago was we created this historical committee to focus on preserving written and oral history, photographic history, preserving historic buildings. You know, in so much of Europe, you know, a building gets old and you preserve it. It lasts 500 years or 1,000 years. Here, if a building is 100 years old, we want to just knock it down and build something new. Come back to take you out to eat. You're lying all dressed up on the bed, and baby fast asleep. We'll go in the bathroom, put your makeup on. We're gonna take that little bride of yours and drop her off at your mom's. I know a place where the dancing's free.